Well, we're gonna start a new game because I don't care about. Actually, let's just check. Autosave. In 2017. Did you play in 2017?
I guess I must have.
But it said you last played 2014.
That's also.
On Steam, at least. So that's strange. Oh, you know what it is? Maybe. No. Could it? Because you own Republic Commando, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Because I was thinking, because I know I own it too. So I was like, well, maybe it kept my cloud save if it was a game share or whatever. But then I'm like, no, it couldn't. It wouldn't do that. It should keep it separate.
Do you think that but, just uses the last change date on a file? And when I move my
that could
game
be.
Files from one drive to another when I change computers?
That could be. Tara's giving me advice on how to make the channel better. And I told her I was going to ignore all of it. So I just sent her that we're going to record Republic Commando, and she said, remember to discuss background stuff, graphics, music, and the story. And I'm like, I appreciate it, but we like being shit.
Wait, what did she say to add?
Remember to talk about the gameplay and the graphics and the story and all this stuff.
Oh, yeah. I do try to do that sometimes, but yeah. Then distracted by talking about stupid crap.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's the whole point of the channel, isn't it? To talk about stupid crap?
Yeah, I think so.
She also really understands how much I like boobs now. Because she's
I feel like some of those are so cringy. No?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I still...
She's fine with it, though. So I'm like, that's good, because I obviously like boobs.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I still have the same enjoyment.
Proclivities?
Yeah, mm-hmm. But at the same time, I'm like, man... Maybe I'm like, put it on a bit too thick.
Maybe. So, can you see okay? Because, I mean, it's...
Yes.
This is a very awkward position for me to be in, I feel like. Having my hand up here for the mouse.
Oh. Yeah, I
also,
forgot that.
Also, the sensitivity is really high. I need to turn that down.
You could do that with the mouse.
Oh, yeah? What's the sensitivity buttons?
I think it's that weird stinky thing on the top.
The stinky thing on the top? This thing?
I think so. It like should change the color of blue.
Yeah,
darker blue is all the way down.
Yeah.
I think.
Yeah. All right, let's see how that is. Nope. Jeez, there's like no middle ground.
I was having that trouble in Halo too.
That's probably fine. It's still awkward for me because I'm just not used to having my. My one arm up like this, and then my other one down.
Yeah, I forgot that people aren't used to that, because I've been doing that for years now, you know?
Yeah.
Especially with, like, Overwatch and stuff.
Mm-hmm. I don't like having to fully extend my arm. That's the main thing. I could be fine with it being up here, but I don't like having to extend my arm like this, so I'm going to scooch forward.
Well, the
actually.
Mic doesn't help, because I usually rest my arm along there.
Mm-hmm. You play like this?
Well, not fully, but, yeah. You know, partially. Sometimes I'll get the titty mouse pad out to rest my...
The titty mouse pad.
To rest my arm on. Wow, look at these graphics and story.
They're from 2004. Or when did this game come out? 2004 or 2003?
That's before I was born. I was born in...
I identify as a 15-year-old.
No, everything was deleted before 2020, don't you know? Our childhood was erased.
Yes, that's true.
You're
being introduced to the squad. You should recognize them. You've seen Clone Wars.
Yes, that's Gibraltar. That's Godolfo. And that's Big Stinky.
Uh-oh. No, it's Sev's Fixer and Scorch. Sev is the sniper, Fixer is the tech guy, Scorch is the explosives expert.
So Big Stinky is kind of close.
Yes, Big Stinky is Scorch. That's Scorch right there. I think we can adjust the graphics too, but it looks kind of wacky. Highest. Why don't I turn up the resolution or should we leave it at 1024 by 768?
So it stretches.
I wonder what we can increase it to.
Oh, not by much.
1600 by 1200.
That doesn't look like it changed much.
No, it did not. Texture quality highest. Bump mapping quality.
Yeah. What the heck does that do?
I have no idea. Isn't a bump map like...
It maps like the...
Yeah, like the textures, right?
Yeah, the textures.
Mm-hmm. Like, so why would you have that on low?
I don't know.
V-Sync, we don't need V-Sync.
Let's go,
Because I think you have like textures, which are kind of like more flat looking, like
lots of colors if you texture a polygon, then it's a flat like a PNG on the polygon. Yeah. So bump mapping, I think would add realistic looking texture to it.
Yeah,
I think.
It's interesting. I watched a video. I guess we haven't played Pikmin 3, so
no, we haven't.
Make a difference, but the Bulborbs look like it's like clearly looks like they have like these big textures and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Like it goes in like on their models, but no, it's just like it's just textures. I mean,
yeah.
There's no
no polygons.
No bumps
there.
On them, yeah, or anything. Right, yeah, they're right, just right. Like a eggplant shape.
Yeah, with the. Fake shadows and whatever else to make it look like it's really textured.
Yeah, because in Pikmin 3, their spots look like they kind of like sink into their body a bit.
Yeah.
Geonosis.
Just a trick of the eye. Zero Hour. This is the Battle of Geonosis.
Also, there's no.
See, that's what the bump mapping does. It makes the armor look a little funky, I think. It's kind of weird. I actually kind of don't like it very much because I remember turning the graphics off way back when I played this back in like high school on a better PC than I had when I was a kid.
Yeah.
And I kind of hate it, so I'm going to turn that off, actually.
I despise it. Maybe exactly. That's why. Maybe that's like the recommended. Like,
yeah, leave it on.
We know we messed up the boat maps.
Yeah, it looks kind of weird.
Or at least on like modern resolution computers.
Yeah, maybe it looks fine on an old CRT back in 2003, yeah. 4, whenever it came out.
Yeah, there wasn't any, like, memorable locations in the new Star Wars trilogy, really, was there?
No, not at all.
New planets.
No, because it's all either deserts, forests, and that's about it. And even, like, Crait, the place where they ended the final battle in The Last Jedi, that was, like, the most unique place because it was salt and it had red dirt and stuff, but still, it's just, like, whatever, that's not that interesting.
Yeah. I guess being on the Sith planet was kind of cool with the lightning.
Yeah, I thought that was interesting. They didn't hardly do anything with it.
Yeah.
They could have tied in. This feels weird. I don't know if I like it. Whatever. I'll deal with it.
It'll be like Doom where we spend the first episode adjusting our settings.
Yeah, right.
Hey, everyone. I'm gonna, like, have motion sickness editing this.
Yeah.
I don't actually get that.
Let's just give all the viewers...
I know some people do, though.
The non-existent get, like, viewers. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. I've never had a problem with that, obviously.
Yeah, same. Which probably means you'd handle VR fine.
I would hope so.
That way you'll never know.
Because I'll never play VR.
Oh! Did I say you'll never know? I meant you... You never know.
Ah, yes.
I don't know.
I know what you mean.
I can't talk. I was...
that's why we're a Let's Play channel, because we can't talk.
I don't realize until I watch back our sessions, I'm like, wow, I can barely speak English. There's so many times where, like, you completely understand what I say, I'm like, wow.
That was not coherent at all.
I can't understand what I say. That's like the learning curve to hanging out with me, I think.
It's because I'm part of the Goiter Collective.
Yes.
So Tara wants to join in on a Let's Play session at some point. So I was thinking about inviting her next week.
Yeah, that'd be fun.
So
do RuneScape.
We could do the ask her to be my RuneScape GF next week.
Or we could play VR Paradise.
Is that the porn one?
Probably not. Yeah, there's plenty of options for that.
Yeah, indeed. Whoa! Watch this.
Wow.
Now watch the windshield wiper. Oh, yeah. I love the attention to detail in this game.
Yeah. Why did they never make another one?
I don't know. It did very well, and it's very much beloved by the fans. But, yeah. I think they had a sequel planned, but it got cancelled.
And they just never had the chutzpah to pick it back up.
Yeah, well... Especially now because motivation. Of the Disney buyout.
Yeah, and it's probably too violent for like a Star Wars game for them.
I don't know about that because
even the movies weren't as violent, were
they? No, they weren't for sure. They definitely toned it down.
Yeah,
and like even the games are kind of PG. Even like Jedi Order was pretty good, and it was, it wasn't super violent or anything, but I mean, they didn't let them do any dismemberment of any humans at all, because they said, oh, we're saving it for impactful moments or whatever. And I'm like, okay, but all these other Star Wars games before have all had all kinds of dismemberment. You play The Force Unleashed or Jedi Outcast or whatever game it is, there's all kinds of dismemberment all over the place.
Yeah. So, it's quite strange.
Indeed.
But is there any dismemberment in this game?
I don't think so.
Yeah, I wouldn't suspect as much.